Welcome to Kevin's Stories. I told you about the first time I got mugged. How about the last time I got mugged? This was it. This was the end. You know, this was closing out, you know, this was Derek Jeter closing out a first ballot Hall of Fame career. To be fair, I actually thought I was already in retirement at this point. So it's really more like, you know, Muhammad Ali coming out of retirement to get beat up by Larry Holmes, you know, or Trevor Burbick. I think that's an apt analogy. I would say I'm Muhammad Ali of getting mugged, and pretty. But I also want to point out that this is the only time I got mugged in New York, you know, fully mugged. You know, there was an aggressive pickpocketing. There, you know, there was some other sort of half-assed muggings, getting yoked or whatever. But this was the only, like, full-blown mugging I ever experienced in New York. And it's also, I always talk about whether something was my fault or not, you know, in terms of Kevin's stories. Was it the hashtag Kevin curse? This was hashtag Kevin curse. I could not have been doing less, you know, less wrong, really, when this happened. I wasn't, like, running wild in a foreign city, like, in a bad part of town at 3 a.m. or cutting through, like, a vacant alley in a bad part of town. I was doing nothing. I was walking home. Bob Dylan played Prospect Park in, like, I should have looked this up. 2010, I think? You know, or around there, 2009, 2010, something like that. And Prospect Park in Brooklyn. And I went to it. And on my way home, I stopped at the bodega, you know, to get some ramen and some orange soda, you know, some health food. And I'm walking, for those of you who know Brooklyn, I'm walking down Park Place. And I'm right past, I'm between Vanderbilt and Underhill. A couple blocks from Soda on Vanderbilt, you know. And it is kind of a dark block. And also, I don't know if the guys did this, like, knocked out a streetlight, but there's a streetlight out. So almost this entire block was, like, really dark. It was, like, summer. Or if they just picked it because it was really dark. But so I'm walking along. And I hear, you know, somebody kind of jawn at me, you know. And it's like, generally just ignore people when they try to engage you in situations like that. So I just keep walking, you know, and finally this guy, like, catches up and gets, like, right, you know, so he's kind of in front of me. And he's like, "What do you got in your pockets?" And, you know, like, this wasn't my first rodeo. And I was like, you know, this dude only looked like 18 or 19, you know, and there's only one of them at that point. He's not, like, got a gun or anything, you know, yet. So I'm just like, I'm going to fucking menace this guy, and he's going to chicken out, you know? Because I've been in other situations where, like, you know, a guy would, like, grab my hands and, like, tell his friends to go through my pockets. And I would just, like, twist out of it and, like, stare him down and keep walking. And they'd usually, you know, back off. That happened on Franklin Avenue, you know, not long after I moved there. And I just kept walking and acted like I was, like, texting on my Samsung phone and acted like I didn't give a fuck. And you know, they backed off. So I literally was like, you know, I was feeling bold, you know. I got that revolutionary spirit of Bob Dylan in me. I like, just dropped my groceries and I was like, "You're not getting shit. Get the fuck out of here," you know? And, you know, try to be as menacing as you can when you're, like, you weigh, like, $135. And he's like, "How about this?" And he pulls out, like, this fucking, like, trench knife, you know, like, brass knuckles with a knife. All the, like, Carol from Walking Dead, except it was, like, cheesier than that, even though it was, like, a big fuck-off knife. And it had, like, spikes on the, it was just, like, kind of, it looked like some shit you get at, like, the Army Surplus store back in the 80s when you could still get shit like that. Or, like, you buy it at, like, a carnival, you know, and you'd get a sweet dragon and skull ring with it and shit. It was like that, except it was a big-ass knife and brass knuckles with spikes on them. So I was like, "All right, dude, I got a dollar." And, like, right when I'm reaching into my pocket, I get fucking hit from behind, right? the hits, the classics. I get this time at least my cheekbone had fucking shattered, which was good because I didn't have healthcare at that point. So I just get hit from behind and I go down. And this was, you know, when you reminisce about your career, you know, when you run the highlight reel, it's like this was the only time where I ended up on the ground and with a knife on my throat because they got me down and literally like had the knife on my throat like Law and Order style, you know, like that's the only time that's ever happened. And it was like three dudes at that point. And the funny shit was like they started trying to go through my pockets, but I was wearing, you know, like I had on my like $200 APC jeans, you know. And they were, you know, pretty tight. It was the indie rock era, you know. They couldn't get their hands in my pockets, so they basically made me do it. They made me mug myself, you know. I reached into my pocket and I pull out my keys, and he just grabs them and throws them, right? Because they want to get rid of you after the mugging. They don't want you to fuck with them after it. And they, you know, it's almost like they knew me because that's my move, you know, like you go after them after the mugging, you know, but they threw that. And then like, you know, I had a piece of shit, like clamshell Samsung phone with like no battery cover. And they took it, you know, because that's worth big bucks. And then, you know, I was like, here's that dollar I was telling you about. And I did actually say that. I did actually say, here's that dollar I was telling you so much about. You know, because they actually rolled me to the other side so I could work on my other pocket. And I got into there and I was like, here's that dollar I was telling you so much about. And just bam, and they hit me again. And then they stand up and they just start like, you know, like Guy Ritchie movie, just like start, you know, like kicking on me. But they weren't really connecting, you know, because I was kind of like blocking. I took one serious kick to the chest. But, you know, like, it was up high. I didn't, like, break ribs or anything. But I did end up with, like, a giant black bruise a few days later. But they, like, you know, kicked on me, you know, like Lust for Life. You know, like, the Stooges was playing in the background, I bet. Oh, I forgot to tell you. Somebody totally witnessed at least part of this. Because while this was going on, at some point, they all, like, sat up, you know, like meerkats. And were, like, looking around. And then they were like, get the fuck out of here. They're like yelling at someone. So like, you know, some fucking Prospect Heights, AKA Prospect Whites, didn't want to get involved. And was like, you know, okay, I'm just going to keep walking my Bichon and picking up its shit. And I'll let you carry on with your business while my dog does its business. And so, yeah, that happened. So they're kicking on me, and they hit me that one time hard in the face, but mostly I was all right. So when they jump up, you know, because they had my wallet too, which had no money in it, you know. And if you've watched my other videos, it's like hassle people to get your ID back, because getting your ID back is such a fucking hassle. It's like the worst part of getting mugged. And they'll usually give it back to you just to get rid of you, and because they don't even want it on them, you know, like it's like proof that they fucking assaulted you, so they want to get rid of it. So they start running, and I immediately jump up, I leave my keys, and I just start chasing them. They get to Vanderbilt, and two of them, like the ringleader guy, there's always one scary ringleader, and then some dudes who like aren't really sure if mugging is the career for them or not, you know, who are just sort of doing a ride along to see if it's the right choice for them. So the ringleader and one of his toadies who had all of my shit went one way, and the other guy who was actually the smart one was like, knew I'd be chasing them. And so he peeled off in the other direction, you know, he bugged out the other way. So I chased the other two guys, and I was like, you know, yelling like, let me get my fucking ID and can I get that piece of shit phone back? And I round the corner and I lose them, you know? And so I'm like, I stop to see if I can hear them. And then I'm creeping along really slowly and I don't see them. And then all of a sudden this dude comes out and he's like, hey man, are you looking for like two guys dressed like this? And I was like, yeah. And he's like, oh man, you walked right past them. He was like, they were hiding down in that person's little front, you know, these are brownstones in this area, right? There's like a stoop and then like a little garden area. And he was like, oh yeah, they were leaning against the wall. You just missed them. And to, you know, I gotta say, When I remember this mugging, I like that those fucking guys hid from me. That means a lot to me. They hid from me. They didn't just run. They literally, it was two of them and one of me, and they hid from me. You know, when you got a sunny side up shit, like getting mugged all the time, you look for things like that. So anyway, he's like, man, are you all right? Because my face was kind of swelled. He was like, you know, are you all right? Do you want me to call an ambulance? He knew immediately, like, something like that had happened. And I was like, no, don't call the ambulance because I didn't have health insurance. I was like, but call the police. Ambulance comes anyway, you know, in that situation for liability reasons, I guess. And so I waved that off, you know, the hits, right? This time I didn't get to fly to England a few days later to have free surgery, though. But luckily nothing was broken. And the police were like, oh, yeah, they just mugged someone else over in Park Slope and didn't get, you know, that guy didn't have any money either. And so I'm like, you know, the upside is, like, maybe these guys are going to be like, man, mugging is just not paying what it used to. But, you know, I did, like, a ride around for a minute to see if we saw him, and we didn't. And that was the last I ever heard of that, you know? Unlike, you know, that time in England where I got a letter, like, 8 months later, and they're like, yeah, we got those guys. Because some detective was on the case in Jackson, Michigan, NYPD, they're busy guys. So never heard anything else about it. But that was the last time I got mugged. But I got to tell you, $50 for modern Bob Dylan, that was a real robbery. I'm going to get dragged for that. But seriously, it was like Cookie Monster dressed as a Confederate soldier, you know, reading like a Rolling Stone at Deaf Poetry Jam. it was really out and bad, I hate to say. Bob, my man, Zimmy, you're ruining your legacy. You still make decent records. You gotta chill with that live show. Thanks for listening.